今天让 NBA 球员来做球场鉴定，主打一个权威。
有两个是大家比较关心的问题，然后还有一个是我个人作为裁判员会比较关心的问题。第一个呢，就是现在国内有非常多的年轻人在模仿或者是学习一个护球手的这个动作。
I think it's really necessary. I think as a player, I want to do as much as the referee is going to allow me to do. So if they allow me to get away with different things, then I'm going to do it. As long as I keep it in here, like in here my body, the referee will probably not call it. And I'm going to go this way, I'm going to come here like this. It's got to be quick. It's a thing that I do in the NBA that I can get away with. It's probably a foul, but you can't see it. So I'm not like grab all the way like this, because the ref would see that.
有一个动作啊，就是他在他的圆柱体内抓着我的手，你认为抓和这样多抓合理吗？
我感觉 it's gotta be quick and subtle，
让裁判员看不见，裁判员看不到了，那就没有犯规。第二个问题就是 handicap 那个双手推挡的一个问题，一旦有了接触就是犯规呢，还是说这个接触没有造成影响，他去进攻上来，而裁判还是去忽略？
In the NBA, the way they ref is on the perimeter, so out by the three-point line, they don't let you touch someone hard. In the post and in the paint, you can have a lot of body contact.
在不同的位置使用相同的动作，裁判的尺度是不一样的。他认为这个动作会不会对防守者带来非常大的一个困扰
？That's why it's really hard to guard players in the NBA because they don't let you do that.
最后一个拉夫安，作为裁判跟球员，其实在场上有的时候会处于一个对立面，裁判吃出错判，对他有失利的一个情况，他怎么样裁判交流，或者裁判给他一个怎么样的回答，情绪会调整的会比较好。
Player needs to be somewhat respectful to the ref. If I just yell at the ref, that's going to make you defensive, and you're not going to want to talk to me about it. We have this honest dialogue back and forth, and so next time, you know, you'll feel better when you're talking.
兄弟们听见了吗？
球员其实还是喜欢裁判员会针对刚才那起判罚有一两句非常精确的去解释，而不是说置之不理或者是敷衍了事。
Thank you. Yeah, yeah, yeah.